Let us look at the second question. They were saying that for what value of alpha comma p does the following function represent the probability mass function p of x equals to x is equals to alpha p power x for x equals to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on infinite. So what are the conditions for this to be happening? The first thing would be each of the values for each of x equals to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, this value should be greater than 0 for all x. So for this to be happening, you should be having that, let's take the values for x there. If you put x equals to 0, it would be equals to alpha. So alpha should be greater than 0. If you put x equals to 1 there, then it would be equals to alpha into p. So alpha p should be greater than 0. From this 1 and 2, we can see that alpha should be greater than 0. Greater than or equal to 0, that is also possible. And p should be greater than or equal to 0. Both of these conditions are valid for it to be satisfying this probability mass function. There is one more condition, that the sum of all the probabilities of x equals 0, x equals 1, x equals 2 and so on, x equals to infinite should be equals to 1. That is sigma of x equals to 1 to infinite probability of x equals to x should be equals to 1. This implies we substitute the values of here it's x equals to 0. So if we substitute the values of x there, so the expression would be alpha, since x equals 0 in the first case, plus alpha p square, plus alpha p cube, plus and so on, infinite terms, should be equals to 1. For this to be happening, if you look at it, there is only one way this should be possible. This p should be less than 1. Only in this case, this should be converging. This is the infinite series. It would be converging, as we have seen from the geometric progression. Only for p is less than 1, this is possible. And we will be assuming p is less than 1 and solving this problem. So if we assume p is less than 1, then this infinite series sum would be equals to a by 1 minus r. Here a is equals to alpha and r is equals to p. So it would be equals to alpha by 1 minus p. That is equals to 1. So if you solve this, alpha is equals to 1 minus p implies alpha plus p is equals to 1. And we have seen that alpha should be greater than or equal to 0 and p is greater than or equal to 0. We'll be removing the case of alpha is equal to 0, because if alpha is equal to 0, this entire series would be equal to 0, sum would be equal to 0, and we won't be having this condition of sum is equal to 1. So alpha is equal to 0 is eliminated, so alpha should be greater than 0. And p, for this p, it could be 0, because let's say for x equals to, let's assume the case of alpha equals to 1. Alpha equals to 1, this implies p would be equal to 0. What does this say is that only for x equal to 0 we'll be having p of x equal to 0 would be equal to 1 and 0 for all the remaining cases. That would still be the probability mass function. So the values of alpha and p for this it would be possible is all the values of alpha comma p, if you draw a line there with alpha plus p equals to 1, it would be a straight line. Let's assume this is alpha and this is p. This would be equals to 0 comma 1 and this would be equals to 1 comma 0, and all these values falling here except for this 0 comma 1, except for this p is equals to 1 case, except for p equals to 1 case, for all the points in this straight line, this condition would be satisfying. For any value of alpha comma p, which in this triplane, this is alpha plus p is equals to 1, or if you consider this as x and this as y, you can write it as x plus y is equals to 1, but x would be equals to alpha and y would be equals to p. So all the points that are in this where alpha is greater than 0 and p is greater than 0, for all the elements of alpha comma p, this would be possible. This condition would be applying. So that is the second question.